Oh yeah, time for season three, everybody. Let's make it sure that this season three is the best one yet. It's gonna be great. I got big plans for this season. Big plans indeed, yes. Everybody say hello to Twitch chat there on the left, out there in YouTube land. We have Twitch chat going this time, so hopefully people will be able to keep track of how I'm interacting with chat in the future. I thought it would be a nice change, and it doesn't make the screen look weird, so awesome. Another thing, for those, I know a lot of you are already familiar with this, but anybody who's new since I've added it, if you check under Channel Points Rewards, you can use your Arty Bucks to play sound effects during the game, and I've chosen some pretty great ones. Go ahead and have fun with that. It'll probably make for some hilarious moments. Anyhow, welcome to Season 3. Alright, we got a new coach. We were the Monsters last year, and we had two losses. Every last one of them. Well, we probably won't be killing people this stream. It is Little League Baseball. But, I mean, hey, you never know. I've given people concussions in the past. What's up, Vince? Nice to see ya. It's going great. We're about to start a new season. So, I guess before I create the new coach, I've got a couple of goals for this season. My main goal, go undefeated. I don't want to have any losses by the end of the season. It's a tall order, but I'm hoping we can get that. Second thing, I do want to have at least one game where I get at least 20 points. That would be so nice. Also, if we can get home runs with all of our characters, that's also great, but that's a little less of a priority. Anyhow, let's get a new coach. I am still Artie. Artie's already in your list of coaches. Please choose another name. Well, There we go. No one will ever know the difference. All right. We are Artemis. Mobius, thank you for the 100 bits. All right. This is great. Your generosity is greatly appreciated. All right. So, season setup, we're still playing on hard mode. Medium mode is way too easy. Like, the computer boys don't even try. Still going to do 6 innings. As much as I want to turn off errors, I'm afraid that that's just going to be like everyone catches everything, so we're going to leave that on. We're going to have swing spot still on, no pitch locator.
This is big brain time.
As you can get a look at some of the alerts we have. Alright, we need a home... Little Toon Cat, thank you so much for the sub! Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Thank you so much. Enjoy your new emote or emotes, and enjoy your gold banana. Oh, this is fantastic. You guys are the best. All right, we need a home field. Last time we had Steel Stadium. I do love Steel Stadium, but I think we're going to make it the Playground Commons this time. We didn't play on this at all last season, but we played on Tin Can Alley like 8 times. I want to play on this. It's a great field, so as much as I love Steel Stadium, Playground Commons.
What's the score?
Also, hi, Marty. So did I put, like, a cooldown on any of these? Probably not. Oh, well. Okay, we need a new team. So season one, we were the junior all-stars. Season two, we were the little monsters. I think we've graduated from little now. But we're still, let's see. We're not humongous yet. Little, mighty, red, super duper, white, blue, crazy. We're green. Not in terms of color, we're in terms of like, we're still a little green. We're a little new. I don't know, guys. Melon heads, wombats. I kind of was thinking about the fishes, to be honest. You know, he looks so happy. I do think we need a new team. We're not going to be the monsters again. The green wombat. We could go for the wombats. They look chubby. The green purple fishes. I was kind of thinking the fishes. What color? Purple fish looks pretty cool, to be honest. Blue fish is also interesting. We were blue season one and green and purple season two. Green. Okay. I like the purple fishes. We'll go with that. What should the secondary color be? Again, already don't have no eye for design, so I need your guys' help. Not green. We were purple and green last season. Also, not purple and purple. We need to have some eye for design. Purple and yellow? Yuck! Those are opposites! The only reason I'm saying not purple and green is because we were purple and green last season. We were THE hacker. It was amazing. We could go yellow. I kind of like blue. Or black. Or red. Purple and yellow literally go together. They're polar opposite colors on the color wheel. Purple is made from blue and red, and those, and then yellow's the other primary color. They're literally at the opposite ends of the color wheel. That's why they go together. Oh, okay. All in favor of purple and yellow? You are correct, Marty. I was never a little girl. Okay. If we can be purple and yellow, that's fine. Not my first choice, but you know what? I want to make Twitch chat happy. And hey, you know, that's not, I guess it's not... To be honest, people, the only reason that I'm actually kind of being like, I don't know about that, is because yellow is like one of my least favorite colors. That's okay. Purple and yellow. Yeah, this will be an interesting team. We won't look like anybody else. So there we go. Let's go. Pick the kids. Okay, so... How we picked kids last year is I had 4 characters return from our previous year, season 1. I personally picked 4 new players, and then I had Twitch chat vote on a new player. This time I'm going to pick 4 players from last season to return, and I've also got... Every last one of them. That got dark. But... This time I'm going to pick 4 players from last team, from last season, season 2, that will return. I have 2 people in mind that are going to join me, and then I have, for the remaining 3... I'm never going to get anywhere with this. You guys just want me to stream until 10:30, and that's why it's taking forever. There will be 3 new players that will join, that I will have Twitch chat vote on. They could be players from a previous season, or it could be new players. Not pros, though. I'm not picking pros, there's a variety of reasons for that. But if you guys want a custom character, I will go for that, but I will have the final say in what the custom character will be. Now, having said that, let's start the picks. So first off, we're picking Pete Wheeler.
Pick me for your team.
Pete Wheeler was by far my best character last season, and he was really good in season 1, and I said last season I'm going to make him team captain. He's team captain. He's absolutely amazing. Welcome, Janae! You're just in time. We're first picking the characters. All right. Second pick, I mean, come on. You know it's got to happen.
I'm the best, you hear me? The best.
Now, I know some people were saying, oh, you really should ditch Tony because he's not that great and the meme's getting old. And I thought about that because I know people want me to pick Angela. Angela's a great player. Thought about it. But I realized Tony's got to finish off the Star Wars trilogy, you know? It's the last movie. He's got to finish off the trilogy strong. And will he go to the dark side or will he become a full Jedi Master? We'll have to find out now.
Listen here, Slick. You made the right decision.
There you go, Tony. You're my number 2 pick. All right. And now, obviously, you got to pick Pablo.
Hola. Soy Pablo. Gusta mucho el béisbol.
You got to pick Pablo. Excelente. He's so good. All right. Now, 4th player. Now, these 3 players I picked for all 3 of these seasons now. They were in Season 1 and Season 2. I really want to go for my man, Dimitri. Dimitri is just such a solid player. He was fantastic. He had some hilarious moments. But I've actually decided against it. Against all odds, I'm going to pick, out of all the characters to return this season...
Nothing I look better than the player sports all the darn day long.
We're picking Mark DuBois, everybody. Marky was a shockingly great character last season. He was hilarious. He got the home run. He was really good defensively, too. So...
Not done. I'm gonna play.
Yeehaw! Dimitri could come back. If people want him to come back, he can. You can vote on that, and I would be happy to see him back, because he is a very solid player. Now, as for the 2 new players, one player that will be adding brand new to this team this season, they just barely didn't win the Twitch poll last season for Season 2. Just barely got beaten out by Maria Luna. It's Sneezy Kid, a.k.a. Mikey Thomas.
You ought to pick me for your team. I'm pretty good.
Mikey, he's one of the best batters in the game. He has an amazing arm, pretty good fielding, but there's no way he's a 4 at running. He's a 1.
Okay, I like playing in the outfield.
There we go. Mikey Thomas. Another player I'm going to pick was not a person on my Season 2 team, but was on my Season 1 team. It's my old, reliable pitcher, Lisa Crockett.
I really want to kick me.
Lisa Crockett's coming back. I did not like Lulu. Lulu was, well, she had some high highs, but some extremely low lows. I think Lisa's going to be an overall better. How is she only a 6 at pitching? She's amazing at pitch. She's one of the best pitchers in the Dane game, unless she got nerfed in this version. I hope not. But she played really well defensively in the 97 version. I'm assuming she'll play well this time. Otherwise, we in trouble.
Neat.
Okay. That's 6 of our players. We have three.
I believe you.
We have 3 remaining spots, so this is where Twitch chat needs to come into play. I want to hear your guys' opinions of who we should add to our team. These can be players we've never had before. They could be players that we had last season or even in season 1. Doesn't matter. It's up to you, but there's a bunch of backyard kids we have not picked before. So, I want to hear your guys' ideas. Popcorn Boy. All right, well, that's 2. That is 2 votes for Dante Robinson, 1 vote for Stephanie Morgan. Stephanie Morgan would be a solid choice. Are there any backyard kids I've never used in a team? Yes. I have not used... Actually, it would probably be easier to mention the ones that I have had before. So I've had Kenny, I've had Lulu, I've had Jorge, I've had Keisha and Dimitri. I have had Jocinda and Maria Luna, and both of the cons. We have 2 votes for Stephanie. All right. I don't know how many people are out in Twitch chat, so it seems like Stephanie and Dante are 2 of the popular decisions. All right, I like that.
You should pick me. I got a pretty good arm.
Dante's also a fast boy, so this could be great. Who's their translucent kid with the question mark? That is a custom character that you can make. So I am totally down for people to vote for custom character, but I get to choose who the custom character would be. Oh yeah, that's one fan. You can't vote for pros. I'm also not taking Angela Delvecchio because I don't want both of the Delvecchios on the same team. Because that'll turn Tony to the dark side for sure. And also, I'm okay with people voting for Billie Jean Blackwood because even though she gets worse if she's on the same team as Marky, Marky gets a big boost. So it kind of evens out. All right. So right now it's a tie. 2 for Dante and 2 for Stephanie. So I think we can pick both of them. Otherwise, we'll be here forever.
My dad played in the minors, you know, and he was real good until he got injured because he hit so many home runs and got shin splints from running the bases, but he taught me everything about baseball, and I know it all.
Okay, that's great. Yeah, we want you.
Right now, you play me at shortstop, and we'll win for sure, because I've studied tapes, and tapes are the best, like Ripken and Rodriguez and Pascal, and I can turn doubles all day, you'll see.
Thank you, Stephanie. You seem very knowledgeable about baseball. We'll definitely make you our shortstop. All right, last character left. We have 2 votes for custom character. 1 vote for Annie Frazier. Annie's solid. There is no way Annie's that good at batting. She's solid, but she's not that good. All right, that's 3 votes for custom. That's pretty good. That's pretty good. Okay, 3 votes for custom, 2 votes for Annie. All right, both solid picks. People could be tiebreakers. Oh, you also said Annie? Oh, never mind. It's a tie now. It's a tie between custom and Annie. All right, we're gonna need someone to break the tiebreakers. Can we make a custom character of Arthur? Maybe. The custom character creator in this is exceedingly limited. It's nowhere near as advanced as the hockey or basketball ones. Well, it's free versus free. I know there are other people out there in Twitch chat. So, we need someone to break the tie. It's free for Annie.
Oh, are you having cake?
Either that or I have to serve as the tiebreaker. Which I could do that. I would not be opposed.
Objection!
Yes, the custom character peeps are more vocal. That doesn't make you better. I am definitely leaning more towards custom character though. Okay, I'm gonna give it 20 more seconds for people to get an extra vote in, otherwise I'm gonna be the tiebreaker. Marty, if your college friends are watching, then they can vote as well. Even though they don't have their own Twitch chat. We really want Cranky Kong.
You know what's the most exciting thing about winning? It's when you win. I love that feeling.
If... Oh man, if I really, really wanted to be... If I really wanted to make it interesting, I'd be like, whoever donates the most gets to decide. No, I'm not going to be like that. Alright, it's been 20 seconds. We're going custom character, y'all! Alright.
I'm going to put some dirt in your eye.
Yeah, these are very basic kid skins. Alright. I can't even change the hair color on them. Alright. I feel like that's probably the closest to Arthur's face. I like the idea of making Arthur the character. Yes, it fits on. Yes. All right. Gets a nickname. T-Bone, Boom Boom, Spaz, Sparkles, Pickles. He's a genius. Oh, man. What nickname should it be? Please pick Lucky. If only Cheater was one of them. Oh, his Lucky Pencil! Oh, yeah! That's good. That's good. Oh. Also, I need to look up when Arthur Reed's birthday is. Because that's actually revealed. Arthur Reed birthday... May? Oh! That's right! Arthur's the same birthday as Marty! May 25th! It's your birthday. Arthur, I think, is right-handed. That makes sense. Alright, now comes the hard part, the stats. His birthday is actually revealed. Yeah, it is! Alright, do we want Arthur to be able to do the big hit? I don't know. Arthur was not the pitcher on the... Actually, Arthur plays baseball in some of the episodes, and he's really bad at catching the ball. So maybe we put all of his stats into batting and running. Arthur did. His doctor prescribed them, so it's okay. There is one episode, Arthur makes the team, where, like, he joins the baseball team, and, like, he keeps dropping the ball. Is he particularly fast? Look, I'm just going based off of the Arthur episodes. Realistically speaking, he'd probably be not that great. It's Francine who's the real superstar in this. I'm trying to remember. Does he? He doesn't pitch, no. I don't think so. I feel like I need to watch... I should have watched that episode beforehand, but I didn't know I was picking Arthur for my backyard baseball team. Oh my gosh, we're already almost a half hour through the stream. I gotta... Okay. Maybe... I don't think he's... he's not maxed at running. No way. Let's maybe do something like... that. I think that's... I think that's about right. His batting is good enough that he can pull off the big hit. Arthur's pretty fast in the TV show. He's not terribly great at pitching, but, like, I mean, it's possible. And then he's fine at fielding, so... Mav, thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. Welcome aboard the Backyard Baseball Express, population Playground Comics. We've seen him be bad at fielding but not pitching. That's true. All right, we need to move on, otherwise we'll be here forever.
If you pick me, I'll let you be my friend.
Sure.
Excellent.
I say no. All right, here's our team. We have Pete Wheeler, Arthur Reed, Pablo Sanchez, Stephanie Morgan, Master Tony, Mikey Thomas, Marky Dubois, Dante Robinson, and Lisa Crockett. Guys, I'm so excited for this. Like, this is a really solid team right here. We don't have... Our only weak link is arguably Marky, and he's only really weak at batting. I'll let you be my friend, Cooks, though. It's like I spent 15 minutes making Arthur Reed, and then I say no. Oh no, it is Arthur without his glasses. Well, that's because the character creator is super limited. What you gonna do? Also, oh my gosh, those outfits look terrible. Oh no, what have we done? Oh well, it's fine. That's gonna be the trophy we win, folks. Yes, it is. Oh my gosh, our first game is against the Pirates. And they're one of the two teams that actually beat us last season. The band of misfits. Oh, this is gonna be good. Oh, I'm so excited, guys. This is what a fantastic team. All right, let's get ready for our game against the Pirates. Yarr! Start the first game. All right, let's see what our guys are like. Stephanie Morgan is normal. Mark Jaboya, oh, he's not doing so hot. He's even worse at batting today. Pablo's also got a decrease. That's not good. Dante is his usual self. Pete's his usual self. Mikey's good. Arthur Reed is pretty solid. Tony's good. And Lisa's good. All right. So let's organize our team. Lisa's going to be our main pitcher. Stephanie's definitely going to be shortstop. I like Master Tony as the catcher. I think he did a very good job with that. I definitely liked Marky in the on first base. I like Pete in the center field. Dante's pretty good in the outfield, if memory serves. He's fast and pretty good at fielding. And then Mikey's a bit slow. But he's got the greatest arm in the game. Or we could try Arthur in the outfield. We might mix it up as we go. We might have to because, well, I mean, Lisa probably can't pitch forever, right? All right, and now the all-important batting order. Pete's obviously going first. I'm not sure if I want Dante second. I might want to break up my route. Nah, Dante second sounds pretty good. Let's move like Mark. Here's the thing, though. If Mikey... Let's have Mikey as our third batter, because if Mikey either gets a home run or he gets out, there's no in-between. So let's try to break up some of our slow players. Lisa's going to be bottom, because she's really bad at batting. Yeah, that looks pretty solid. Let's see their lineup. What do they have? All right, they have... Oh, no, Jason Kendall. He's the guy who got a home run on me last season. He's nasty. Alan Holzman? Okay, he's really good at pitching and pretty good at batting. Buddy Martin sucks. Vladimir Womack, also kind of bad. Maria Luna! Oh, she turned against us, but it's okay, because she got all the decreases. Rose Flugel? Oh, good at batting. Watch out for her. Judy Abunza? All right, she's fairly fast. Trent Sizemore? Ooh, he's dangerous. And then, oh no, not Ramona Quimby. Uh-oh. All right, folks, let's get game one of season three started right now.
Arthur makes the team.
Ah! Welcome back to Baseball Fever, all you crazy fans. Hiya, folks. Welcome to Backyard Baseball. I'm Sunny Day, along with my broadcast partner, Vinny the Gooch.
Folks, we're gonna bring you the best in baseball today. Home runs, triple plays, strikeouts, live action from some of the hottest players in the league this season. The best in baseball.
Boy, you're sure enthusiastic today.
I had a good breakfast. This afternoon will feature a fierce competition between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the Green Fishes. Hey, kiddos, don't forget to buy your raffle tickets. We've got a humdinger of a grand prize this season. A year's supply of bubble gum chew. Just think of it. You could chew for a whole year without ever stopping.
Alrighty then, it's time for some baseball.
I love how we're the green fishes and we're purple. It's like, we're not green like the color green. We're just like, we're still relatively new, you know? Like, we still aren't as established as the Pittsburgh Pirates, you know? If Arthur doesn't get a big hit this season, I'm going to be sad. So am I, Marty. So am I. So I just realized with Arthur on our team, oh my gosh, I'm going to have fun making the thumbnails for this season. It's going to be phenomenal. And we're at Playground Commons, our home field. Oh, this is going to be fantastic. I should have named myself Arthur. I regret that. But Artemis is also fine. All right, folks. Time to play ball! Good to have you back, Lisa.
If it curves or catches fire, Mad Dog can throw the heck out of it. Just don't ask her to throw a slow ball.
Watch me now. Hey,
Judy Abunza.
All right. First at bat, Judy Abunza. All right. So Lisa doesn't have a great heat or a slow ball, but both of her hooks are amazing. And those are the best pitches. Okay, Judy got a solid hit. Get that, Steph. Oh, that's not a good start, Steph. Steph, you said you were good at shortstop. This is not a good start. Oh, it's Ramona Quimby. Oh, she's got an invisible increase. Oh, how lovely. Oh no, I picked Dante. He is the most annoying chatter ever. I just realized. Dante has the most annoying chatter in the whole game. And so does Marky. We have... we're literally the team that just heckles other people. Oh, Lisa. That's not how you're supposed to do it. Marky! What's wrong with you, dude? Oh, you got the minus one... Marky got the minus one decrease in fielding, and that has screwed him over. Great. Alright, Flugel. Thank goodness the out of play didn't have him go beyond second. Lisa, please don't make me regret bringing you back. You were so good in season one. Oh, I'm not blaming anybody for Lisa. I'm blaming Lisa. I'm not blaming any of Twitch chat for Lisa. I'm blaming Lisa for Lisa. Or the 2001 version for ruining her.
A bouncing ball. Hit a little number to the mound. And the throw to first and go. Chucked it over.
Lisa, this is not a promising start to your career. You've already made like two or three errors. And it's the first season. Oh no. Not Big Head McGee.
Man, he can really run, folks.
Runner on third, two out.
Yeah, so last season this guy hit a home run very unexpectedly. On sandy flats. Okay. Pablo, grab it. Or Stephanie, just get him out. Marky, please catch this. Thank you. Okay, that was close. Alright, it's okay though. We got a pretty strong batting lineup. Pete, Dante, and Sneezy Kid. Everyone's favorite. Vinny didn't have anything to say about Alan. He's not that great.
What? What am I supposed to do again?
Well, it's just like riding a bicycle, Pete. You just got a bunt. Oh. That is not the trajectory I was expecting the ball to go in. I thought it was a slow ball, and then all of a sudden, it curved. Uh-oh. All right, Pete, we're going for the old reliable grounder. Does Pete do anything but bunt? He can wall up the ball. Oh my gosh! That was a beautiful hit, Pete. Alright, what kind of an arm does she have? Decent enough. Okay. Nice single, Pete. Can you forget how to ride a bike? Oh boy, here he comes.
Bring on the meat!
Alright, Dante! That was a delayed bunt. Like, he took, like, a good quarter of a second before he actually stuck the bat out. Yeah, it is a bit of a small field. Sure, just... Thank you, Jason. He's a little slow. Can't forget how to ride a bike if you've never... That's true. Let's see if we can steal Fern. Uh-oh. Forgot about the delay. Oh wait, nope. Go back, Pete. I forgot. Yeah, pro players generally have a good arm on them. Okay, I can steal second, maybe not third. This is what I remember about Dante. He's fast. He's pretty good at fielding. He's a decent backup pitcher, but man, he just can't hit the ball, man. Oh, there we go. I take it back. Oh wow, their pitcher is even worse than Lisa was. He literally just sat next to the ball for about 3 seconds, like, what do I do? All right. Yes, Mikey. Oh, sure, please. Please let Dante steal. Who is their catcher? Jason Kendall. He's a pro. He's got a pretty good arm, but not good enough to go to second. All right, Mikey, get us our first home run of the season. You'd best be afraid of Mikey. Look at how big his bat is. He might be sick. Sick of you! Is that a home run? No, no. Please bonk into each other, though. Ha ha! Okay, that's the problem with Mikey, though. Mikey either gets a home run or he's gonna be out because he's too slow. But this is why I put him before Pablo. Although Pablo is a little sick today, but he's still like 9 out of 10 at batting. Alright, Pablo. Let's get a bona fide Pablo Sanchez secret weapon home run. But not on that. That's a ball. If their catcher was worse, I would have Mikey steal. Whoa! Is that even over the fence? Yes, it is! First home run of the season!
What's the score?
Now that's how you start out a season, folks. Even when he's having an off day. Oh, I just realized, Arthur Reed, if he gets a home run, I don't think he has any music, so I can put in custom music. I can put in the Arthur theme song. Oh, that would be so good. Okay, all right, Marky, we got 0 outs. There's literally no pressure. Okay. not your best effort there, Marky. Please drop it. No, that's okay, Marky. Oh, yeah. All right, Tony. This is your Furred movie. Everybody knows in the Furred Star Wars movie, the main Force user has much better powers. Anakin was amazing in Episode 3, Luke was amazing in Episode 6. Rey was super powerful in Episode 9. Oh, darn it, Tony himself. Well, Tony in Season 2, he was having the lapse. And again, that's kind of what happens in Star Wars movies. Like, Anakin has his, like, whiny angst moments. Luke abandons his training to save his friend. Actually, Luke doesn't have a lot of personality flaws. Bad example. I'm more comparing Tony to Anakin. He might turn to the dark side at the end. Whoa! Someone say Jedi powers? Oh, don't catch that, though. Oh. All right, Arthur. We gotta hit the big hit. We gotta get the big hit with Arthur. We gotta Photoshop. I wanna replace the portrait down there with actual Arthur in the YouTube VOD. Oh, what a wallop! Oh, that's a foul. That's a shame. That was a great hit, Arthur. Just aim a little more inside next time. Maybe I can still put in Arthur music over the generic theme that plays for him. That's just what I need. I need more editing. I need to spend more time editing these videos. No! Oh no. It's because Arthur didn't cheat. We know Arthur can't win if he doesn't cheat. All right, Trent. Man, Lisa, you didn't get any energy back. Nice catch, Marky. Good job. Let's shut him out. Use the Hey, It's Franklin music. Just Hey, It's Franklin coming down to play. I don't know how the theme song goes. I know the first few words. You know, considering you got all the decreases, that was a pretty powerful wallop there, Maria Luna. That's probably because she's upset I didn't pick her again. Maria, you were just kind of meh last season. You weren't terrible, you just weren't that great. Alright, thanks for the strikeout. I need more juice. I can't find Juicy Juice at the grocery store anymore. Oh, wait, I forgot. I have in my hands, in classic arty fashion, food to eat during the stream. These are Kirkland brand signature milk chocolate covered raisins from Costco. Every time I score a point, I will eat one. I forgot to eat some, so I'll just have to eat as we go. These are amazing. If you have a Costco card, definitely get them. Hey, buddy. You're getting out. Oh my gosh, he's so slow. I should have let him go to first. Oh wait, no. That was free outs. Never mind. No double play. Lisa didn't even bother picking up the ball. That's just the kind of lady she is. Alright, Stephanie. You're a pretty solid player. I would say Stephanie is possibly the most average player in the game, but she's pretty good.
Okay, I'm just gonna keep my eye on the ball and knock the cover off of it.
Sounds good. Let's do a line drive.
Here's the pitch. The wing.
Nice one! Ooh, what a hit! Speed up, Steph. Ah, not quite fast enough. Uh-oh. Easy out!
Give me something I can hit.
Please?
Into the motion and deliver. The wing.
Okay, that's an out.
Bouncing ball.
Then I'm scrambling.
Eh, she almost made it.
Ooh, that's not what we're looking for.
That's okay. Now we're back to the strong part of the lineup.
Can he hit the ball?
Two out.
Yes, he can hit the ball. What are you talking about?
I'm gonna hit a touchdown.
Well, actually, you're gonna bunt. Oh, wait, what? Oh, okay, cool. Everybody was like, we knew he was gonna do that. Oh my gosh! I almost went the second. Do it on Arthur. Crazy Bus! Arthur would hate it if I played Crazy Bus for that. I'll play the Binky song. Which is actually apparently a real song by a real Finnish band. Don't know what the lyrics are. They're all in Finnish. Darn it! I keep forgetting that he has such a lone windup on his bunt. Wow, the third baseman is slow. I'm gonna try. I'm gonna try to steal again.
The windup and the throw.
There we go. Oh, what a hit. Oh, that was beautiful, Dante. Alright, Sneezy Kid, we're counting on you.
Mikey Thomas comes up to the plate.
Seems like Nugget has an endless supply of boogers, because he's always picking for them.
One right down the middle for me!
Heck yeah! Alright. Mikey Thomas, he's terrifying.
And the offering.
Well, that's a foul. Darn! That would have been such a good home run if it weren't a foul. Actually, no, it hit the fence. Never mind, it wouldn't have quite been a home run. But you see his potential.
From the windup and the throw. That was ball one. He goes for it.
Oh, you got the powerful glove. I just realized, why did I do that? I mean, if Mikey don't get a home run, it's done. Unless they walk him. That's definitely a possibility.
This is big brain time.
It really is. Ho-ho! Goodbye, baseball. Oh no, that wasn't a home run. It's okay, that looked like it was a home run. Uh-oh. Slide to it, Dante! No! Oh! Darn it. If I wasn't so arrogant that it was just gonna be a home run, I would have gotten home. Darn. That's okay. We got a point! That's cool. Another chocolate cover raisin from me. Hey, Vladimir Womack. Let him go. Let him go.
Put some dirt in your eye.
Lisa. They don't call her Mad Dog for nothing, you know. She's just like, give me the ball! Give it to me! It's part of the strategy! It's part of the strategy. He's super slow, so maybe we get double play. And oh, wait. Wait, what's Alan like? Oh, he's also slow. As long as he doesn't wallop it out of there, which I don't think he will, even with his pretty decent batting. Okay, Lisa. Lisa did that in the 97 version as well. She was hyper-aggressive. Again, I think it's in character for her. Her nickname is Mad Dog. Alright, that's what I want to see. Alright, there you go, Stephanie. And there you go, Marky. Catch it. Yeah, power up for us! Yeah! Okay, Judy's pretty good. Judy's a judge, so she's pretty good. We kind of need a juice box, though. I forgot to oh, there we go. Nice job, Marky! Good job, boy! Yeah. Aw, oh, it's a shame that we have Pablo up first. It seems like kind of a waste. That's okay, maybe he'll hit another homer for us. Oh, also, what's our special bat? Probably Undergrounder. Or Screaming Line Drive, that's good too. It's arguably the worst of the special bats. But it's still solid. You can still potentially get a home run with it. Maybe I'll save that for Lisa. Definitely not saving it for Pablo, he don't need it. Okay. You know what, he'll probably still get on- oh wait, no, that's Jason. Aluminum Power Bat, first game of the season when you're up by 5 points. That would be a little unfair. Yeehaw! It wouldn't be a bad choice right now, but let's save it. Alright, now try to get out Pablo, not Marky. Darn! Okay, nope, no! It's okay, Marky, you tried. Technically, Crazy Bunt is worse. Crazy Bunt's just unpredictable. Sometimes it gets caught immediately, and sometimes it's like, well, that's a free triple. Whoa! Now that's a beautiful shot there, Tony. Pablo can go home. I'm Pablo, go home. Come on, that kid's got a cannon. Nice job, Tony! Chocolate-covered raisin for me. They're healthy, you know, because, you know, raisins. Alright, Arthur. Time to show people who cleans their driveway. I'm expecting great fiends from you, Mr. Potter. Uh-oh. Well, he did pitch 54 times in a row, so that adds up. You want to walk, Arthur? Do it. Arthur. I said more distance, not less. Nice job. Nice job, Tony. Way to not get the double play. That's good. I'm proud of you. Alright, Steph. You're 0-for-1, but that's okay. Let's up that batting average. I couldn't, because I don't know what his stance is, but I'll take your word for it, sweetie. That's the thing, because Tony's in front of her. So they both have to advance. Oh! Okay, run, Tony, run.
That little blooper sent him running.
It's the slide. Okay. Now we're going to pull out the screaming line drive for Lisa, because that's the only way we advance. Nice job, Steph. That was a great hit. She very well could foul the screaming line drive, but this is my only chance. There is no way she's going to advance everyone otherwise. Unless she gets walked. I would not be opposed to that. Then Pete Wheeler home run. Ooh-hoo! I mean, wrong direction, Lisa, but... Actually, that might work. What's her arm like? Oh, yeah. Run, Tony. Oh no! Oh! Yes! Way to bait him! 7 points! Another raisin. Alright, Pete, you ready for a home run? Tony totally duked him. That was great.
What am I supposed to do again?
You're gonna hit a touchdown. Pete, you're a great hitter. I believe in you, buddy. Don't swing at that trash, though. Don't you dare try to bean the team captain. I made him team captain because he's the smartest. Well, second smartest after Marky, obviously. I'm sorry, but Dimitri's not on my team anymore. I don't have brains. Also, apparently there's an internal stat called in-game IQ. Have no idea what it does, but apparently it exists. Are they going to walk? Actually, walking Pete Wheeler would be a good move for them, because Dante is nowhere near as good at batting. Yeah, actually, if they walk Pete, I probably won't be able to get anyone else home.
From the stretch, 3-1 pitch. Swinging.
Oh, no. That's not good. All right, I got to duke him with Stephanie. What a maroon!
I like candy, but everybody likes candy. That's why Halloween is such a popular holiday.
Dang, my team is on point. This is great. Darn. Had to happen eventually. It's okay. We did great that inning, folks. Aw. Oh. It's okay, Dante. Ramona and her twin sister Rose, and then Jason.
The fishes are swimming their way to the top.
You wouldn't think a team like the Pirates would be getting by the fishes in the sea that they roam, but you'd be wrong. Oh, I just realized, do I have any backup pitchers besides Marky Dubois? Maybe Dante's okay? I didn't really think about that. Marky's a solid enough backup pitcher. I don't think we have to worry. All right, Vinny, I trust you completely. Vinny! All right, Steph, is this going to become a reoccurring theme with you, just getting hit in the shins? Vinny, you're supposed to be on my team. It's home. It's the home game. Now Ramona got on base. Uh-oh. Oh, dang! Dante, show us your chops. Catch that. All right, show us your chops by throwing this. Actually, Dante, you got a pretty good arm. Okay, Dante's actually got a good arm. I'm surprised. I don't know, I'm Big Head McGee. Do we have showers at the Playground Commons? I think it's just the park. Okay. Lisa, grab it, throw it for Pablo. Wow. Pablo. It's okay, we're still 7 points up, but Pablo, come on, you're the secret weapon. Oh, that's right, Pablo's the secret weapon, but he can't catch anything. That's kind of why I was thinking maybe Pablo in the outfield. And maybe Dimitri infield. Or maybe Mikey Thomas infield, honestly. Okay. One of you do that. Get him out. Okay, good Pablo. Good Pablo. You actually got them out. Wonderful. Okay. Okay. Maria's gonna do nothing. Tony, you had a spectacular last inning. You've had plenty of action. What? I'm sorry, she had all the decreases. All of them. You fool. What? Tony? What do you mean you stepped off the base? What a goofus. That should have been an out. Oh. The umps. Okay, hang on. There's Maria Luna. Oh, batting was the one thing she didn't have the decrease in. Okay, that's my bad. Forgot about that.
The wind up. Pitch on the way.
All right, buddy. That was my bad. I thought she was like a free at batting. No, she's still a... Okay, that makes a lot more sense, because Maria is actually pretty good at batting. Okay. Pablo, get this. Throw it to Arthur. Arthur caught the ball and got a double play! Nice job, Arthur. Oh, I'm so glad you're on my team, buddy. I literally need a set of set of Twitch alerts. That's just Arthur talking. All right, Mikey. Dane, Mikey with a 1.0 batting average. Ooh, an undergrounder. Marky's pretty good at defense. He did drop the ball right at the very beginning, but he got that out of his system. Wonk. Ooh, impressive. I'm not sure if that's going to be a home run, though. No. But maybe... Is this actually going to be a double? My gosh. Mikey Thomas got a double. I don't think that's ever happened in the history of backyard baseball. He's like the slowest character in the game. What are you talking about, Vinny? He's so slow! Because he has to keep wiping his nose as he goes. Pablo also with the 1.0 batting average.
That's a slow roller.
Slide, slide, slide!
And he's out.
Pablo didn't... Oh, that's right, you can't slide into first. For some reason. We're going underground with Marky. Marky, we gotta give you a batting average. Mikey's like, wait, you want me to steal? I don't know what that is. That was a slide. I would love to get an underground rule double. That would be so fun. Come on, Marky. No! Don't foul the ground underground. Oh.
It's like you gotta have ESP to know where that thing's gonna pop up.
They have a runner on second.
No! Marky, no! Oh, this is bad.
Here's the motion. The 1-2 pitch. A swing.
Marky, no! Sorry, coach, did I do bad? Kind of. Just a little bit.
Have a runner on second, one out.
It's okay. Even if he gets out, we'll have Master Tony up next. Please, tire yourself out, Miss Rose. I'm okay with that. No sweat off my back. Can we bait them with Mikey? We can! Oh no, Mikey's going to third! Better throw it there so that way... Oh, the AI are stupid. Alright, we're gonna keep doing line drive with Tony, because Tony's powers just go straight up. Whoa! What a hit! Right into the fence, come on. Oh my gosh, that was such a good hit. Actually, Mikey, go home. Everyone advance! Actually, no, Tony, go back. I don't trust that. Yeah, Tony's definitely doing real well this season. Much better than the last two. Alright, Arthur, did you bring your pencil? Because otherwise, go back and grab it. Come on, Arthur. Arthur, I so desperately want you to get the big hit. Okay. That was a pretty big hit. Go home, Marky. What's your arm like? Not very good. But his arm is, so... Nice job, Arthur. Okay. Uh-oh. Arthur's beat up! That's fine. Stephanie got... Oh, wait.
Runs to win a game.
Shoot. It's Lisa up next, though. We're not getting any more points, I don't think. Unless Lisa pulls off a Christmas miracle, I don't think we'll be advancing the players.
Give me something I can hit.
All right. It's a tall order, Lisa, but I've seen you hit it into the outfield multiple times before. Okay, well, maybe we can distract them. Nah, there's free outs, so... What? What? Okay. My thoughts exactly. We're gonna hit a touchdown. That's what we're gonna do. Ooh.
Not even close to that one.
Thanks, Vinny. Come on, this is a golden opportunity. Yeah. No. Did you? Wait, what? No, no, Lisa! Darn it, I could have gone home there, couldn't I? Their third baseman. Sorry, I lost track of what was happening myself. Oh, Lisa started moving because Pete was moving towards her base and she had to. Uh-oh, gotta fix that batting average.
Bring on the meat!
Probably not a power, but let's try a line drive again.
From the windup, he throws it.
Stop throwing it low down! Down till you can't hit the low down ones!
Objection!
From the windup and the offering. That was ball one. One and one.
Oh, please. Please. Walk, Dante. It would be the cherry on top of the bowl of stupidity that you have going on right now.
That was a ball.
The Sunday of stupidity. This would be the cherry on top. Okay. Ah, they're all waiting for us, though. Oh, but they... Oh, my... Lisa! No, not you! No, no, not you, Pete! Oh, my gosh. That should not have happened. That should not have happened! She threw it, and she dislocated her shoulder twice. She dislocated her shoulder twice! Mikey Thomas Grand Slam. Make it happen. Come on! It'll be fun.
A swing. Popped it up.
No.
Like a can of corn for the opposing team.
Come on. Hurry up, Mikey. Oh my gosh, Lisa.
And the runner scores.
Vinny the Gooch loving that.
This is still the fourth inning.
Pablo Sanchez steps in.
Even though the secret weapon doesn't speak any English, we all know he's a rat.
You know what would be... You know what's probably gonna happen? Paolo's gonna get a single, and then Marky Dubois is gonna mess it up. No! You know what? That's fine. After the comedy of errors that was that inning, I can't be upset about that.
The fishes are leaving them in the dust. Up by 11.
Things are going swimmingly today. Remember that fishes game way back in early 97 when the whole playing field collapsed in a giant sinkhole and filled with water and both teams had to put on water wings and finish up by playing water polo since all the baseball sank?
No.
I'm pretty sure you were there.
No, I wasn't.
Yeah, you were. You had a pair of water wings too and got a bad sunburn and wouldn't share your popcorn.
Oh, that game.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Okay, Lisa needs to step off the mound. Alright, Marky, I think, is basically our only other option as a pitcher. Oh, Stephanie's alright, I guess. Dante's okay. I do not trust Lisa on first base at all. But at the same time, I kind of can't replace them with someone in the outfield. Arthur, it's time to step up. Hey there, folks! Mark Dubois out! We're gonna have some fun today!
A blooper in foul territory.
Marky Dab.
The stretch.
Oh, that's right. It says Marky's a good pitcher. He really ain't. It's like he's got a good heat and maybe a good left hook. Yeah, heat and left hook are his two good pitches. If you want, Nate or Tooncat, you can post the link to the Discord for Backyard Baseball in my Twitch chat. I think it should work. Uh-oh. Aw, Lisa. Oh, never mind. Look at how slow. No, let him. Let him? Let him go. Let him go to first. That was one of their pitchers that I think pitched 54 pitches in a row, and he hasn't had his juice box. Come on, just barely hit it, Alan. Or just get out. Okay, sure. Nice job, Marky! I know it's not actually his... Marky's voice is a little bit more like this. Oh no, Judy's good. Yeah, Judy's pretty good. Okay. Lisa? Okay. Mikey. Yeah, alright. Darn it. That's fine. Even Mikey couldn't have thrown it to first in time, so that's fine. Let's just get out of the inning. Oh no, Ramona Quimby! She's good. Again, we're the green fishes in terms of skill level, not in terms of color. What the? That was a big bounce. Alright. Arfer, catch it. Nice job, Arfer! Marky's like, I'll let somebody else pick it up. Yup. Oh, wait, that's Goofy. Never mind. Oh, wait. Shoot. If Marky's up at bat by himself, he's in trouble. Nobody's on base to distract them. It won't. Narrator, it won't. Debating on power of Marky, to be honest. No, you know what? Marky power. Why the heck not? That was Marky Dubois hitting a power. Wow, the first baseman's not even doing anything. First baseman's like, I'm gonna sit this one out, coach. Alright, Tony. All of Coruscant is watching. You've had two fantastic line drives today. Oh, what a... it's not even a foul. Nice single, Tony. Man, Tony's quite consistent this season. This is great. I knew he'd be good in the third Star Wars movie. All right, Arthur. I want to see the big hit. Big hit, big hit. That was way up there. Way up there. Don't try gaslighting me, game. I know what I saw. Nah, that wasn't a big hit at all.
He's out of there.
No! No points that inning. And they have a special bat. But it's okay, because we're still 11 points up.
The fishes are in the lead, up by 11. Rose Flugel steps up to bat.
Derp-a-dee-derp-a-dee-derp-a-dee-derp. You think you stand a chance against Dubois? You don't! I don't care if you hit one today. That was when Lisa Crockett was pitching. Marky's gonna get one by you, no sweat. Vinny fought in Vietnam, didn't you know? That's a pretty good hit.
Easy play for him. Rifled it. Throws it over.
Not even bothering with the double play, because this is going to be the last inning. Alright, Jason. In there like swimwear. Classic line from Spy Fox. Alright, we should not be throwing the same pitch every single time, otherwise they might catch on. Probably shouldn't throw the heat to him, though. Oh, nice try, Arthur. Almost. Nice teamwork! Almost got him out. I'm proud of you guys. Alright, Trent.
The
Did you just tell your... Oh, wait, no, that was me. Oh, yeah, they have a power-up. How did I forget?
It's like you gotta have ESP to know where that
thing's gonna pop up. Oh, sure, just give him the ground rule double. It's not like you had me foul my undergrounder. That's fine. So they advance two bases. Okay, remember, Artie, Maria Luna does not have a batting decrease, so... Also, she might have another undergrounder. I would fully expect it. Because they are 11 points down. Remember when I was boasting about how good Mark... Yep, I knew it.
An undergrounder! My, oh my!
All I can say is I can dig it, baby!
Oh, Mikey. 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 Mikey.
On to second. Safe on second.
That was embarrassing, Mikey. I know you're slow, but you ran past the ball there, buddy. Marky, I'm giving you one more chance, but if you can't get this guy out, then we're going back to a new pitcher.
Give us another one, baby.
It's okay. Mikey just had to sneeze and didn't see the ball.
A blooper in foul territory.
Can I turn off chatter just for Dante? I would love that.
Get him, purple. Chopper to third.
Let's go, purple.
Got it.
Go, purple.
Fires it over.
Let's go, purple.
Let's go, purple.
We're trying.
Trying to get something.
All right, Marky. I told you to get him out, and you didn't. Oh my gosh, Lisa's still super gassed. Pablo's even worse than usual. Stephanie's also... Okay. We gotta bring in Dante and put Pablo in the outfield.
We've got Dante Robinson.
We could also play as Tony.
Has a solid set of core pitches. His crazy pitches could use some work. Especially his slow-mo ball.
Okay, that's bad. Oh. Why do all my guys have good left hooks? Right hooks are better. Right hooks are better against right-handed batters, and most batters are right-handed.
The stretch and delivery. The swing. A blooper in foul territory.
Dante looks so happy that he got chosen to be the pitcher, though. It's adorable. Okay, actually, Dante's main pitches are all pretty decent, except his right hook. Which is a shame, because right hook is the best. Nice job, Tony! Uh-oh. You're not allowed to do that if we don't have free outs. We're trying to go purple, but it's hard. Alright, Alan. You're 0-2 today. You ready to be 0-free? You ready for that? So help me, Arthur. Throw it home. Wow! Are you serious? Throw it home!
What a team, folks. When things got rough out there, these kids hung in and kept playing their hardest. This victory is a well-deserved payoff for a job well done.
This is Sunny Day and Vinny the Cooch saying see you next time.
Yar, dead men tell no tales. Well, we pulled through at the end there, folks. That was good. I mean, not at the end there. That was embarrassing at the end. But 13-4. I bet you we beat the other teams by more than the others. Yeah, 13-4. Okay, the Indians got 11 points, and whatever those are, got 10 points.
Oof. You know what's the most exciting thing about winning? It's when you win. I love that feeling.
I do too. Melonheads, you didn't do so hot, did ya? That's great. All right, I want to see what the team standings are. Or, I'm sorry, statistics. Pete Wheeler is best, these are just my characters. League leaders, that's right. Samuel Middleton got 2 home runs. Dang, nice job. Uh-oh, we got Jocinda Smith and Akman Khan and Jorge. Oh, I'll be going up against Jorge again. That'll be fun. Pete Wheeler and Mikey Thomas have the most hits. And Tony and Dante. Okay, top four are all me. This is great. Oh, we have Amir Khan as well. Gotta watch out for that. Oh, Billie Jean. I wonder what'll happen when we play against Billie Jean, if we do. Oh, Keisha Phillips also. Sydney Weber. Oh, no, not Henri. That's not good. Okay, okay. Yep, yep. Dante and Pete have the most steals. Makes sense. Oh, my pitchers don't even come close to strike out. We did not strike out very many people. Uh-oh. Lisa Crockett already is in top for errors. That's not good. All right, that was game one. That was awesome. Definitely a memorable first game, no doubt. I'm really glad Arthur is on my team, even though he didn't perform as well as I'd hoped for. He's going to make for some funny situations, I think. So, yes, this is going to be a fantastic season. I'm glad you all chose to join in for that, and I hope you guys tune in Wednesday, 2 days from now, 8 p.m. as usual. We will be playing the Cardinals in an away game. So, that'll be interesting. We'll see how our team fares against a new team. One in a unfamiliar home field. So homie if it's Tin Can Alley. I am sick of playing on Tin Can Alley. We had that like 8 times last season. It wasn't even my home field, and we played on it almost as much as my home field. Anyhow, I think that's pretty much all the time we have today. Actually, wow, we ended pretty much right on 9:30. That's usually how long these streams go. I'm surprised, considering I spent a half hour talking about the opening and how and making our team. So maybe these streams will be a bit shorter than what I'm used to. All right, I think I'm going to sign off there then. Thank you all so much for joining in. This was a ton of fun. And thank you all for being a nice interactive chat. Really appreciate it. You guys are awesome. And I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of your night, a good start to your work weeks, and God bless.